Hi, welcome to the EfficientIP Network Object Manager demo. With today's network complexities, companies are looking to automate their operations, especially when using cloud. Which brings us to Kim. Kim is part of the cloud management team. She manages all the cloud resources in the company. She makes sure it's reliable, flawlessly, and securely. In other words, cloud instances need to be inventorized and documented in a network source of truth, so the whole lifecycle can be managed. Okay, Kim, show us. When Kim needs to deploy a new instance in AWS EC2, she uses an infrastructure as code software to automate operations. She has to build a new application with two servers. At this stage, there are no instances deployed. Using Network Object Manager, or NOM, Kim will create all required new objects in the Network Source of Truth repository. She starts with the web server instance and sets it to the AWS EU West 3 cloud as planned for the time being. Then, she adds an interface and connects it to the port 1 of the existing virtual switch. She configures an IP address on this interface. Now we have a server called Web1 with an interface connected to one port with an IP address. Its state is planned, and it will run on a T3 Nano instance on the demo environment. Once she has created a new object in the Source of Truth repository, she runs the infrastructure as code software. Kim uses Terraform here. As you can see, Terraform integrates with the Network Object Manager server list and capabilities through APIs to build and update the infrastructure on AWS. And once done, it also updates NOM with the results. But as the Web1 server has set as planned in the repository, Terraform hasn't created on AWS yet. When she sets it to active and reruns Terraform, we can see this time the Web1 server is added to Terraform and built on AWS. Once again, NOM is updated with the results. The Web1 server appears on EC2 console with the parameters set on NOM. Kim needs to create a second database server for the application she wants to publish. This time, she uses a server template that is already created by copying the model into the demo folder for the new application. After setting the DB server active in NOM, she runs again the orchestration. The two servers are added to Terraform and built on AWS. For the first one, nothing happens, as it already exists on AWS. But for the DB server, which is new, it's added to AWS with all parameters set in NOM. Terraform has updated NOM with various information, including when the instances were updated for the last time by the orchestrator. As part of the cloud instances lifecycle, when a server is no longer required, its state can be set in NOM to retired. Running the orchestrator again keeps the Web1 server, but removes the DB server as described in Network Object Manager. And this is reflected on the EC2 console. The DB server has been decommissioned. On NOM, the DB server object has been updated by Terraform. We can see that the instance ID is now empty while all other parameters are preserved. So you can easily redeploy this instance in the future, set it to active, and then simply run the orchestrator again. The same retirement process can be applied to the Web1 server with the same results. And regardless of the number of modeled objects you have, using Dynamic Topology Map, NOM offers the capability to visualize how you are connected in your public and private clouds. When either modeling, creating, checking the state, or decommissioning, with Network Object Manager, Kim is able to fully manage the complete lifecycle of cloud instances using a single source of truth repository. Well done, Kim. As you've seen in this demo, Network Object Manager maintains a comprehensive and trusted repository, making cloud operations much more reliable, secure, and open across any cloud. Feel free to contact us for more information.